And it's time to continue the games between Chris and Doubt. Two fantastic players. Next game, game 8 here between them, is the Vikings War on Ghost Lake. Interesting setup. And let's see how players are going to do here. Should be really interesting. Vikings, never predictable, I feel. Anything can happen. It's not like, you know, you can't really go Nightline, Imperial Age, or whatever, but otherwise it's still happening. And in other civilizations, you know, in Imperial Age, as Chinese, you want to get a Chukunu house, Mongols without your Mangada, you're screwed. As the Vikings, anything can happen. We most likely see sea trams and Arbalest, but might be standard infantry, we might see champions. Berserks would be awesome to see, it's unlikely, sadly, but let's see. 3-4 between the two players, so only one game, only one win difference. Really awesome to see, and players are scouting around. Let's go for the maps first. We can see main gold and main stone for Doubt on the side here, also second stone on this side. Could be walled off really easily here, have three resources, very safe. Also this one could be walled up. Then we have a second gold towards the back here, a board towards the back. Barriers on the side, one board to the front. Doubt needs to make sure this is not stolen, not happening for now. But Chris is sending the scout already. There's four deer, it's not too far away, but we won't really find them. Chris almost saw the deer, saw the sheep, but not happening for now. And Doubt sending the first villager here to get the boar in. Chris might lose the scout, it's not good, did not pay attention here. And scout is gone, that's very bad for Chris. Now Doubt has no problem getting the boar in, doesn't even need to worry about this. Barriers mid coming up, of course. Chris getting the first boar in as well, and it's running back. Wow, that's not good. Losing the scout and then the boar running back. It's okay, should be fine. Yeah, looking good. And boar is in safe. Second boar also to the front. Very, quite huge hill on the front here for Chris. Not too nice for him. On the other hand, easy wall off here. Second gold to the front, second stone to the front. Main gold on the side here, kind of in the back, one gold in the back, main stone in the back, could wall on the left side as well. Not sure how much players are actually going to wall. I think I missed Doubt's third gold, which is also in the back for him. Doubt's maybe a little bit better. It's ice is very close, but otherwise easy wall, no hills around space, at least not two big ones. And this one in the back, he should be able to protect here with the main gold. Shouldn't be too much of a problem. Now even Doubt trying either to steal a boar, block the boar maybe, taking a few hits from the TC. Should not lose the scout though. Yeah, 6 HP remaining. And of course, while Chris has almost no information about the map, he doesn't see anything except for the TC. Doubt can now scout around Chris map and can see where to find the golds, the stones, where is the woodlines, and so on. And then let's see what players are going to do. Drush FC is always an option, but only 3 villages on wood for Doubt here. Looks like gonna go feudal age while Chris doing the barracks. We're on 21 population though, and Chris not going to feudal age. He's got 20 gold in, as far as I can see. No loom done, but 20 gold. And villagers injured, but the scout low HP. Militia coming out. It's okay time, maybe a little bit late. One militia, maybe just to get a little bit scouting. No, he's going for the rush here. Doubt has seen the barracks, of course, he knows what to do. And I think Doubt, let's see, is he going for feudal age? 23 population and up, 22 villagers. A lot of sheep here, of course, with Ghost Lake, we got a few sheep on the map here. And Doubt has food, like, for into castle age, maybe. Finally losing the scout because attacking a villager here. Chris has not found the sheep in the back here, doesn't even see the deer. That's not too good for him. Three militia now going out, and I think Doubt won't have too much problem defending this. The barracks will be up before the rush is arriving. And now let's see what Chris can see here. Doesn't even see the barracks. He would have tried going on the right side probably. Can see the houses now, he knows. Doubt is up to feudal age. There's a little bit housed, a little bit vault here. Nice. Chris has to go around or to the other side, and he can't really go in because Doubt walling the right hand side. And now the militia trying to go, no, going back immediately. Archer range coming up for Doubt. Chris is up to feudal age. Double archer range for Doubt expected now. We'll go feudal archers maybe on the tower forward when he sees that Chris has walled himself in completely. But not sure yet. Could try to aim for a relatively fast feudal castle age as well. Let's see what Doubt is actually doing here. Archers being produced. Yep, there we go. One archer is out already. But needs to go back. He's gonna lose the archer very fast because three militia can deal a good amount of damage. Now, of course, Doubt going back and the militia have to go away. Doubt will have three archers, three very soon. And he's gonna go aggressive here. At the same time, a lot of villagers in gold, two lumber camps in the back here, and going for a house on left side, probably finishing this wall, maybe towards the back here. Could go for a big wall off as well. Now the militia will go down, and let's go for Chris point of view. Where is he going? He's doing archer range, double archer range actually, not going FC here. Wants to stay in field age a little bit. Maybe even go skirmishers, because a lot of farms up already, the berries will run out very soon, and skirmisher coming in. Expected, blacksmith also coming up. And Doubt probably will know that this is going to happen. Let's see if Doubt is actually only going archers. Yeah, he's gonna find the walls. He's gonna see I can't go in. Maybe can do a little bit of damage on the wood line here. House coming up. And I think Chris will move the villagers same time. The militia is still on the field, but can't do too much damage. He's gonna lose them now. Blacksmith up for Doubt as well. Yeah, Doubt a nice position on the wood line. Blacksmith only coming up, no plus one. The Drush is gone, hasn't done anything really. And Doubt on, let's see, 42 population, Chris only on 37. Village is almost the same, and it's not the same now. But Doubt has more military units out on the field and has to go back now because elite skirmishers in feudal age, only without upgrades, can do a lot of damage against the archers here. Doubt has to go back. Let's see if he's switching into skirmishers as well. No, staying archers. Probably doing the plus one, or is it done already? Yeah, fletching is done for Doubt. Fletching also done for Chris. And Chris can't really do a lot of raiding with the elite skirmishers, but he managed to keep Doubt out of his map, for his base. And Chris resources are looking quite good while the action is happening here. Doubt again losing an archer here. Now Chris going around. Doubt resources not really looking good. He's got a lot of army out, but not enough food or gold to click up to castle age yet. While Chris resources looking very good. Although he's going skirmishers, now he's adding a few archers as well. Can't take this fight really. Doubt going for the hill, even stealing the sheep here. Now Chris with a good amount of army, plus one for both players, and first hits for Chris, good for him. Doubt has to go back, he's gonna try and go for the hill here. Chris with a very good game, in my opinion. He's gonna click up to him to castle age very, very soon now. A lot of villagers on one wood line, that's 12, that's 17 villagers here on wood. Doubt now going for the hill, but Chris is gonna cut him off, call it like this, not sure, but Chris is up to castle age. Doubt not too far away, now on 41 villagers, Chris on 40. I think if Doubt can't do any damage to the walls here to Chris, Chris might have a huge advantage in castle age. Let's see what's going to happen. Chris finding sheep now as well. I don't think he's going to use them. Patrolling on the left hand side, trying to find three archers, and actually Chris is going to find them. The archers will go down, I think. Let's see what Chris is going to do now. Up into castle age, we're gonna see crossbows most likely, maybe even elite skirmishers if there's enough of them. Then we are gonna have siege workshops, and we might see, interesting would be to see knights and mangonels, but for now both players going, more archers, we're gonna see 3 TCs probably by both players very soon. And then again, few fights, maybe a forward coming up next. I'm gonna go a little bit faster now because nothing happening, both players fully walled, Doubt even going with the big walls here on the left side. Chris up first, gonna do boat killer immediately, I guess, and the crossbowman upgrade. Doubt knows he needs to react now, as long as he has more military units, and very good fight for Doubt, actually, killing a lot of Chris units here, but Chris, of course, going back here. Doubt is waiting now for castle age upgrade. He's gonna have to wait a little bit longer. A lot of military units again out for Doubt. He's got a few more. Very forward siege workshop for Chris. I like it. That's a very nice nice attempt to get the map control here. The siege workshop will be a pain in the ass for Doubt. And let's see, Doubt going crossbowman, going boatkinner as well. Let's see, Chris going 1 TC, 2 TCs, and 3, 1 on the backwood line. Very good. A mangonel come out very soon. Oh, let's see, Doubt needs to pay attention here. He could lose a lot of crossbows. Not a good shot. Chris getting the mangonel a little bit too early. Ah, that's one waste of mangonel. TC coming up for Doubt on the main gold. Siege workshop is also up for him. And Doubt still with more military units. Chris should not have taken this fight. This is bad for him. He has a few spread sheep, sheep spread out on the map. Doubt, of course, now going with the crossbowman to try and get a few kills here, try to raid a little bit. Chris right now not doing any more mangonels. Got a lot of wood in the bank, a lot of food in the bank as well. Needs to go for more gold. His main gold is quite safe for now. TC there. Nobody in stone yet, I think. No, Doubt is not in stone. Chris not in stone either. Now Doubt trying to get the hill. Mangonel coming out for Chris at this point. And Chris in the score lead. Five more villages for him. No, Doubt in the score lead, but Chris five more villages. That way around, six more villages even. And Doubt really can't do too much damage. He might go in now. This fast house coming from Chris using three villages. Gonna lose one, and the house is still almost not started. 13 HP only. It's not good. University's up for Chris though. He's gonna lead his units back, and I think Doubt won't get too many kills. Maybe one or two. That's one villager down, two down. And those should not have happened, those kills. Mangonel in the siege workshop, it doesn't really help Chris. At this moment, he needs to defend, needs to garrison his villagers. Oh, the wood line is exposed. If Doubt can see the wood line, he might kill a lot of villagers here. And he's gonna do that. Let's see how much villagers will Chris lose. There's one going down, two, and the villagers can't escape. Three, four, five, six. Oh my god, it's huge. Elite skirmisher done for Chris. Trying to go in, maybe. Mangonel, Doubt saw it, or the Mangonel reacting. Good job for Chris here. Of course, Doubt losing all the army here, but Chris now and 59 villages, Doubt and 66. Very good game for him here. Chris should have really walled this. He should have done this earlier on. A little bit of a mistake. Mangonels 1-for-1, and the Mangonel is out for Doubt here. Looking good now again for Doubt. University is up as well. Ballistics probably done, and players are just going to boom a little bit. Chris with a lot of gold in the bank now. Third archer range is up. I don't think number four here. He's revolved this a little bit with houses, so it should be fine for now. Village is still forward, but can't really do anything. And Doubt resources looking very good this time. He's going to be able to click up to Imperial Age a little bit earlier than Chris for sure. Got his resources safe in the back. Still not going for stone. He could do that very soon now. Doubt does. Yeah, he can actually see that this is probably walled. Doesn't really know it, but he's gonna find out soon. For now, players are just booming a little bit, getting a few more military units out. Chris now with more military units than Doubt. Actually, a lot more. A lot of crossbowmen, but can't really do any damage. Doubt now moving forward. Two mangonels and 10 crossbows going forward a little bit at least. Doubt. Chris has clicked up. Oh, I missed that one actually. Chris clicked up to Imperial Age first. I thought he didn't have the resources, but he has better eco actually. Interesting. That's huge. I didn't see it. Blame on me here. And Doubt, of course, trying to go here again. Let's see if he can go through the houses one more time. Battering room now coming up for Chris. Not sure if that's the right decision here, but he wants to go aggressive. And he's gonna get Arbalest and Bracer immediately, or at least as soon as he can. Arbalest is done. Bracer done as well. Chemistry maybe coming. Oh, ballistics only now. Interesting. And I think Doubt has to go back. Yeah, Chris sent the Arbalest here. He's now going forward. Bedroom I'm coming in. Second siege workshop. And Chris suddenly with a good good position, actually. If he can do the damage now, Doubt might be in trouble. Doubt, on the other hand, is up to Imperial Age as well. Arbalest coming in. Bracer coming in. Chemistry, not yet. Could go for it. Maybe we might see Onages for Doubt. It would be a very nice upgrade here. Doubt now finally deleting the walls, going for more wood. Should consider walling this off again. And now Chris going very aggressive. Mangonel is down. Second Mangonel as well, losing a few Arbalest. And the battering rams on the TC. Well, that's not a good fight for Chris. Under the TC, there's a lot of units for Doubt inside the town center. Villagers going out now. And I think Chris is losing too many units here. Doubt on 121 population. Chris only on 92 now. And at the same time, Doubt is trying to go in here. A lot of archer ranges coming up for Chris again. And Doubt really looking good. Chris resources also looking good, but he is a little bit in trouble. On a chest done for Doubt, very important upgrade here. That's so strong. And the Arbalest almost fully upgraded. Missing chemistry still. But now Doubt two onages here. Chris is gonna be have a hard time to defend this. Moving out now. But Doubt really looking strong here. Should get rid of the double siege workshop, but TC won't really care about it actually. Still nobody on stone, no castles coming up. Doubt is on stone finally, going for the main stone here. Wants to get a castle up at a certain point. And resources looking really good for him. Now Chris managed to destroy the two onages here, but Doubt going forward again with a few arbalests at the same time. Chris will load more units, actually, military units, but now with let's see, 20, 23 more villagers, and that's huge over the long game. That's gonna help him a lot here. Chris again trying. No siege workshop going down. The battery cap ram will go down as well. And Doubt going with the forward archery range has to go back now because Chris a lot of arbalest here. Oh, he's gonna lose. Doubt did not see this, losing like 2, 3, 4, 5 units against 2. That's not good for him. But the captain, oh, might get an onager even. Yeah, one onager going down. But now with the onagers, I think Doubt won't have too much of a problem killing this if Chris is actually engaging. Chris can see the onager getting one. Not a good shot for Doubt here, actually. This shot looking better, but still not too successful. Chris, very nice army positioning here. That shot was good. Nice. Losing a few units now. Siege workshops are finally down. The rams are going down as well. And Chris again has to go back. While Doubt is getting a siege workshop forward this time. Might not get it up because Chris is there with the arbalest. No, Chris didn't see it. And oh, nice raiding. Chris on the woodland for Doubt here. Good job. Doubt has not realized this yet. Losing a lot of villagers at the same time. Chris, no doubt, going forward now. Try and go for that hill, probably. Chris, let's see. Doubt finally getting rid of this army, getting rid of the arbalest here. Also raiding on the left-hand side. Good job here for Chris. He's raiding everywhere. That's huge. But now the onager, and if Doubt is going to get this hill, maybe get a castle up on it. It will be hard for Chris to defend here, actually. Hard to get that back. Good fight for Doubt, I think. He's losing a few units, but he's... killing all the army from Chris here. Chris with a lot of units on the left hand side now. And Doubt getting a castle up in front of his base. Very nice positioning here. Doubt, gold and resources still looking quite good. A little low on wood. Chris, the opposite. Very much. A lot of wood here, actually. But is he going for any... Oh, doesn't have a siege workshop. Only now a siege workshop coming up. And he needs some siege because he's losing so many units here. Elite skirmish is going down in mid-imperial age. But... still, it's costing a lot. It's not like we're in a trash game yet. But Doubt, Chris going in now, has killed a lot of units, actually, and only 4-3 villages now difference. He might kill a few more villages. Doubt, at the same time, trying to go aggressive here, trying to take the control over this hill, and he's got it, actually. Chris is on the left side mining stone here. Don't know if anybody's gotten the relics yet. I don't think so. Chris doesn't have a monastery up. Lost a lot. Wow, I missed that shot here. Look at this. That's beautiful. One shot from the onager. A lot of arbalest going down. Not good for Chris. Did not pay too much attention here. And now Doubt is moving forward, still with the onagers out. Let's see, Chris going for battering ram, it's going down immediately. Should have done the onager upgrade as well. He's trying to defend with rams here. Now rams also coming in for Doubt, who's losing a lot of his resources now. And Chris calling GG. I think this shot that I missed, sadly, I missed this one, that's bad. Maybe gonna edit later on. But that's huge, actually. And I think if Chris had that hill, maybe a castle on that hill, he could have defended. But at this point in the game, Doubt, the superior army, has got 48 military units, and Chris has lost all his army on the forward battle here. So Doubt taking the next game, very impressive, very nice game on Ghost Lake. I like the map, actually. It's it's similar to Arabia, but it has some flair. It has something special, and very good game for both players. Doubt in the end with the better game here. Onager, I think the deciding technology to take this game. And I hope you enjoyed it as well. See ya in game 9. GG.